everyone, it's editing Edo, and before we begin the episode for today, I have a few things I have to address before we push this episode forward. So if you remember in my New Year's video where I was talking about the freestyle battle with Downheart, another thing that's coming up for the channel is me and Downheart, we're going to be hosting a freestyle battle for Zoom. Yeah, about that, it has been canceled because Downheart needed to work more on his music. But a huge shout out to him for the idea anyway. Also, editing Edo audio here to say that I have misplaced my numbers of guests of 10 numbers. We are actually on 29, but we are getting to 30 guests very soon. So now, back to the cold opening. And another thing I have to address, if you're reading this title, you notice that Glide is not going to be the special guest for this. Coming up next is the upcoming cosplayer from Jay Hattori's friends once again named Glide. But I still want to give him his proper shout outs. It's just we couldn't really work it out, but please do not send any type of spam or hate messages towards him and Jay Hattori as well, because my door is still open for him for the interview at any time. And on that note forward, we move to our guest that we have today, which is James Dell from Creative Corner. So here is the episode. Enjoy the theme song. Let's go. Cue.
Talking Farm with Edo Podcast.
Hello, everyone. It's Podcast Edo, back at it again with another episode of Talking Farm with Edo. For this episode, we have the novelist and also the creative content creator of James Dell from Creative's Corner. And now, as usual, let's move on to the interview. It's Podcast Edo back at it again with another episode of Talking Fun with Edo, with now our 29th guest, and his name is James Dell. How's it going today, my friend?
I'm doing pretty good, EDO. How are you?
I'm doing pretty good, too. So I have, like, the list of questions. The one that basically we just start off with, of usual, is where are you from?
Me, I was born and raised in the Bronx, New York, by way of Jamaica. Both my parents are from Jamaica, West Indies, and I am first-generation American.
Hmm. Are you also from Connecticut, too?
I've been living in Connecticut since 2001. My first day I actually slept in Connecticut as a Connecticut resident was when Aaliyah passed away.
Oh, wow. It's interesting you mentioned that because, you know, she was one of my favorite artists as well. And it's actually been 20 years when I realized that she passed away because of when it happened. I was like super young and stuff. So, wow, that's interesting that you share that. And also on the same note, I guess the more likely as a memorial of her, it's now it's been 30 years since she first began, actually, with her first album, AJ Nothing But a Number. So, yeah.
That was I want to say 7th grade, 8th grade, something like that when that came out.
Oh, I don't exist at all. But I mean, like, when I did, it was more likely when she was doing the Mulan soundtrack, and this was when they had the Hot Like Fire stuff. So it was like, or this was like when Missy Elliott, speaking of which, began. So I was born when she did her first album, Super Duper Fly. Thank you for thanks for that memorable thing, because I really do, and still do love Aaliyah to this very day. So
great artist.
Yeah, she was really great. So, first thing I remember seeing from your profile is that you are a novelist.
Yes.
And one of the things I was wondering was, like, how did you, like, create these books? And even for these books, like, how do you even, like, what was the overall messages and, like, topics of how you made these books as well?
Okay, so my first book is a collaboration with my older brother, Matthew. I'm just another hopeful fool in love. The only thing I share is life. The only thing that I'll give is love. It's a book of poetry. So it's a journey on my life of self-discovery. You know, love and lost and everything in between. My second book, which is a follow-up of that, is Politics Is All Political, is a COVID book. You know, so I did that during work, and you know, was on the front line. I didn't have any time off. I went out to work. I drive city buses in Hartford, and during my breaks, I wrote a lot about politics and how the world is run and how people are accepting that time and their lack of going and doing certain things. So that's what that book entailed. I have another book, Bound by Honor, Betrayed by Trust. It is semi-quasi autobiography-esque kind of thing, because growing up in there's so many stories, 8 million stories in the Naked City, and everybody has a million stories. So I incorporated a lot of the stuff that I experienced and other people around me experienced into that book. The other book now, the book that I wrote in Full Sail, it was a project that I wrote for Full Sail. It is an ebook, is not a hardcover for that book. And words are sharper than a sword, is something that I have. It's a lot of short stories. There's one or two poems in there, but it's more or less short stories in that one. And the dun dun dun, the book that I particularly like, you know, it's not my story. This is my first editing job, because that's what I like to do. I like to edit. Is it was written in Vampire's Blood, you know, written by my brother Matthew Dale, and I edited that book. It's a book about a young detective in New York City who was hurt on the job, and her granddad was the pathologist, and he was a vampire, and he didn't want his, you know, only heir to die. So he gave her blood and brung her back to life. And she had to deal with that transition from being of the living to the dead, and having to deal with all of that. So those are my books.
It's interesting, because Written in Blood, it reminded me, I know it's completely different, but my brain picture, do you remember a movie that's called A Vampire in Brooklyn?
Yes.
That's exactly what my brain just left to when I thought of that. Like, but I know it's completely different. Like, it's nothing to say of that at all, right?
No, it's not.
Yeah. So speaking of which, like, of the word Just Another Hopeful Fool in Love, is that also the name of, like, your podcast?
No, it's not. The name of my podcast is Creative's Corner.
That's okay, Creative's Corner.
But Monica, Just Another Hopeful Fool in Love, is the name of my first book. And that is what I, the phrase that I say after I recite my poems.
Mm. So when it comes to, like, your podcast, like, how did you create the name of Creative's Corner? And so far from the people that you interview, who were, like, the most inspiring people that you've interviewed so far?
The most inspiring person that I interviewed so far is the individual that prompted me to want to go in this avenue, is Dr. Jackie. You know, on my book tour, you know, going out there doing cold calls and trying to get bookstores and libraries to display my first book, Just Another Hopeful Fool in Love. I called Dr. Jackie, and she led me to different people who had bookstores. And the one person that she led me to was Dr. Vanjie, the owner of Optimal Gold Radio, where people can listen to Creator's Corner Wednesdays at 6 o'clock every week. Mm-hmm. She was the first person who helped display my book. So without having that call to Dr. Jackie, she's episode 22, I think. Mm. I wouldn't have been the person that I am today. I wouldn't have had that exposure. I wouldn't have even thought to go back to school to Full Sail to further my education in creative writing. So it started with her.
Yeah. Nice. So Creator's Corner, it's also a radio show as well?
Yes.
Nice.
Radio on 6 and on Wednesdays. And it's I do it for Enlistic TV as well on Saturdays. And I have a YouTube channel that I put it on as well. So, and if anybody don't catch the radio show or the showing on Enlistic TV, you can always go to my page, Just Another Hopeful Fool in Love, and catch the episodes.
Nice. So speaking of Full Sail, I want to, congratulate you on finishing it up, especially because I've just finished it up myself. Both of us, we finished it in last year. And I was wondering, what was your degree major in it? And what was, your favorite moments in Full Sail as well?
I went to Full Sail because I wanted to learn how to write scripts. You know, I am a movie connoisseur. And when I go into a movie, whether I'm watching it on Netflix or on Hulu or I go to the theater, I always look at the characters and the development. And unbeknownst to me, that's how writing scripts are. You have your characters and their flaws and what their journey is and what's the obstacles and things of that nature. And I didn't know all the technical terms about breaking down a movie. And I've been doing that since I was a kid, watching E.T. and Malcolm X and Snow Falling on Cedars and things of that nature. So actually coming to Full Sail and learning the technical terms, it came full circle, pun intended, to what my interest is. So going to Full Sail is a great experience, and my script writing classes is the ones that really stand out, with the exception of what's his name, what's his first name. He's a film teacher, and he teaches about lighting and
okay. I think I might remember it too. I'll share not links, but more likely there'll be something that'll show up that'd be like, yeah, this is the name.
Right. So his class was really an eye opener because it talked about the different angles, shots, the camera angles, and putting everything in perspective, and learning about scripts and writing scripts is different from writing poetry. It's different from writing novels. You have to write words that people can actually see on screen, like you being a director and me giving you a script that is written as a novel. You can't film that, but I will have to readjust. I had to readjust my approach to writing and write words that you can actually film, a lot of action words and things of that nature. So that was very challenging for me in a good way, that I have a broader range for writing.
Okay. So one of the things I have, and this is probably going to be the only thing for it, is the usual segment of the first and inspirational. And the thing that I got was, what was the first book that you can remember that you have read? And what was the book that inspired you to make the books of your own?
Okay. The Learning Tree.
Learning Tree.
Right. The author, Gordon Parks, I think his name is, the Learning Tree. That is a book that I read in the eighth grade. And a lot of other books, Still Falling on Cedars and Aliens in the Attic and those kind of books, the autobiography of Malcolm X and Rich Dad, Poor Dad. Those are the books that I've read on my own. That wasn't books that I had. It wasn't a part of the
curriculum.
Reading those books, it especially Gordon Parks, it made me know that I, as an African-American, can write, because in a lot of mediums out there, there's not a lot of representation of our people in certain mediums. So to pick up a book and know an author looked like me and was very expressive and very eloquent with their words in the book, it inspired me to jot down and collect all of my thoughts on page.
So now we're down to like the final part. So one of the things I was wondering is if you have any other upcoming projects that are coming up this year so far.
Other than Creatives Corner, I'm doing a radio show called Stella and Trevor, and we found a animator that is going to animate the show, and that is coming up. That's up and coming. So we're going to do it one episode at a time. We completed about 65 episodes of Stella and Trevor. And those of you who follow me, or those of you who want to follow me, you can check out a lot of the episodes that we have recorded on my YouTube channel.
Nice. I can't wait to see that myself. So one of our last things that we got before we say our farewell is if anybody would like to talk to you and also collaborate with you, where shall we go to go find you?
Well, I'm going to give you the link to my media kit, and people could find me at Just Another Hopeful Fool in Love on Instagram, Hopeful Fool 21 on Twitter, James Dale on Facebook, or you can go on YouTube and jot in Just Another Hopeful Fool in Love, and you'll see this pretty smile on there and Creator's Corner in the background, and you click on that link and it'll take you to my page.
That's definitely best way to find you. And on that note, we gotta say our farewell. So see you later.
Take care. I appreciate your time.
Well, I hope you enjoyed this interview and the shout outs that we have got for Sketch Me Not, Pink Cocoa, The Cynical Clinic, Yougurus Coradonus, David So, the host of Genius Brain Podcast, Mealine Yamaguchi, and Timothy James. Another thing I would like to share with you all is, of course, not even just the link to our own interview that we have from the radio, but also on that note, the video version for the interview with me on Creatives Corner is going to be coming in the next month of March. But I'll make sure to give you guys the details on that. And speaking of being featured on other podcasts, we got the Blerd City podcast, which you can check our episodes of Dan interviewing me, and of course, me doing vice versa. Now, as of other things coming up, it's still in the works. But as usual, I want to leave you guys off with another farewell, and I'm going to see you later.
Talking from with